Namaste. Myself, Dr. M. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I explain the inverse Laplace transform by the Convolution theorem. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the student will be able to find the inverse Laplace transform using Convolution theorem. Come to an example. Using the Convolution theorem, find the inverse Laplace transform of s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 whole squared. Solution. Let s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 whole squared can split as the product of the two functions, that is 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 into s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5. Let f of s is equal to 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 and g of s is equal to s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5. Now find the f of t and g of t, that is f of t is equal to L inverse of f of s, which is equal to L inverse of 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5. F of t is equal to L inverse of 1 upon s plus 1 whole squared plus 4, because by making the perfect square, and that is f of t is equal to e to the power of minus t into L inverse of 1 upon s squared plus 4 by first shifting property, that is equal to e to the power of minus t into sine 2t by 2. And g of t is equal to L inverse of g of s, which is equal to L inverse of s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5. Then by making the perfect square, the s squared plus 2s plus 5 can be written as s plus 1 whole squared plus 4. That is L inverse of s plus 1 upon s plus 1 whole squared plus 4. Therefore, the g of t is equal to e to the power of minus t into L inverse of s upon s squared plus 4, because by first shifting property. Therefore, the g of t is equal to e to the power of minus t into cos 2t. By the Convolution theorem, we know that L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to the integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. Therefore, the L inverse of s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 whole squared is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t, and then replacing f of t by u and in g of t minus u, it becomes the e to the power of minus u into sine 2u up by 2 into e to the power minus t minus u into cos of 2 into t minus u into du. Therefore, the L inverse of s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 whole squared is equal to 1 by 2 integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power of minus t into sine 2u into cos 2t minus 2u into du, because by using the law of indices, when the bases are same, they add their powers, we have, that is e to the power of minus u and minus of minus plus u will get cancelled, that is e to the power of minus t is left. Now while at integrating with respect to u, the t is treated as a constant. Now take it as e to the power of minus t as outside the integral sign, that is e to the power of minus t by 2 integration u is equal to 0 to t 1 by 2 into sine 2u plus 2t minus 2u plus sine 2u minus 2t plus 2u into du, by using the basic trigonometric formula, that is 2 sin a into cos b is equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. Therefore, that is equal to e to the power of minus t by 4 into integration u is equal to 0 to t. In the plus 2u minus 2u get cancelled, that is sin 2t, and 2u plus 2u, that is 4u. Now, on integrating with respect to u, e to the power of minus by 4 into sin 2t integration of du is u between limit 0 to t plus the integration of sin is minus cos 4u minus 2t by 4 between limits 0 to t. When substituting the upper minus lower limit, that is L inverse of s plus 1 upon s squared plus 2s plus 5 whole squared is equal to e to the power of minus t by 4 into t sine 2t plus 1 by 4 into minus cos 2t plus cos 2t. That is plus cos 2t minus cos 2t get cancelled, and that is equal to e to the power of minus t into sine 2t by 4. Pause the video and write the answer for the question. What is the L inverse of s plus 2 upon s squared plus 4s plus 13? Solution. By making the perfect square, the denominator can be written as L inverse of s plus 2 upon s squared plus 4s plus 13 is equal to L inverse of s plus 2 upon s plus 2 whole squared plus 9. Then by first shifting property, L inverse of s plus 2 upon s squared plus 4s plus 13 is equal to e to the power of minus 2t into L inverse of s upon s squared plus 9. That is equal to e to the power of minus 2t into the L inverse of s upon s squared plus 9 becomes the cos 3t. Now come to another example. Find L inverse of s upon s to the power 4 minus 16 by Convolution theorem. Solution. Let s upon s to the power 4 minus 16, which can be split as the product of the two functions, s upon s squared plus 4 into 1 upon s squared minus 4. Let f of s is equal to s upon s squared plus 4 and g of s is equal to 1 upon s squared minus 4. To find the f of t and g of t, that is f of t is equal to L inverse of f of s, which is equal to cos 2t, and g of t is equal to L inverse of g of s, which is equal to sin h to t by 2. Then, by the convolution theorem, we know that L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u into du. Therefore, the L inverse of s upon s to the power 4 minus 16 is equal to integration u is equal to 0 to t by replacing in f of t, t by u, and in g of t, t by t minus u, and it becomes the cos 2u into sin h2 into t minus u by 2 into du. Now, is equal to 1 by 2, which is the constant take outside. 1 by 2, integration u is equal to 0 to t cos 2u into e to the power 2 into t minus u minus e to the power of minus 2 into t minus u by 2 into du. Because by using the definition of the hyperbolic function, the sin h theta is equal to e to the power theta minus e to the power of minus theta by 2. Now here the theta is equal to 2 into t minus u. Now that 1 by 2 is the constant taking outside, which is equal to 1 by 4 integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power 2 into t minus u into cos 2u into du minus integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power of minus 2 into t minus u into cos 2u into du, which is equal to 1 by 4. While I have to integrate with respect to u, treat theta as a constant, which is taking the outside of the integral sign, that become e to the power 2t integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power of minus 2u into cos 2u into du minus e to the power minus 2t integration u is equal to 0 to t e to the power 2u into cos 2u into du. But we know that integration e to the power ax into cos bx into dx is equal to e to the power ax upon a squared plus b squared into a cos bx plus b sin bx. That is, L inverse of s upon s to the power 4 minus 16 is equal to 1 by 4 into e to the power 2t into e to the power of minus 2u upon minus 2 squared plus 2 squared into minus 2 into cos 2u plus 2 into sin 2u between the limits 0 to t minus e to the power of minus 2t into e to the power 2u upon 2 squared plus 2 squared into 2 cos 2u plus 2 sin 2u between limits 0 to t. Now, substituting the upper minus lower limit, it becomes the 1 by 32 into e to the power 2t into e to the power of minus 2t into minus 2 into cos 2t plus 2 sin 2t minus of bracket minus 2 plus 0, close the bracket, minus e to the power of minus 2t into e to the power 2t into 2 cos 2t plus 2 sin 2t minus of 2 plus 0. Now, the multiply the entire term by e to the power 2t and this second term by e to the power of minus 2t and simplifying, we get that is equal to 1 by 32 into minus 2 into cos 2t plus 2 into sin 2t plus 2 into e to the power 2t minus 2 cos 2t minus 2 sin 2t plus 2 into e to the power of minus 2t minus 2 sin 2t plus 2 sin 2t will get cancelled, and that the remaining terms are becomes is equal to 1 by 32 into minus 2 cos 2t plus 2 into e to the power of 2t minus 2 cos 2t plus 2 into e to the power minus 2t is equal to 1 by 32 into minus 2 cos 2t minus 2 cos 2t, that is a minus 4 cos 2t, that is a minus 4 into cos 2t plus 2 into e to the power 2t plus e to the power of minus 2t. But we know that cos h theta is equal to e to the power theta plus e to the power of minus theta by 2 implies the 2 cos h theta is equal to e to the power theta plus e to the power of minus theta. Therefore, the L inverse of s upon s to the power 4 minus 16 is equal to 1 by 32 into minus 4 into cos 2t plus 2 into the e to the power 2t plus e to the power of minus 2t becomes the 2 into cos h 2 theta, that is 2 into 2, that is 4, the cos h 2 theta, which is equal to 4 is the common, 4 by 32 into cos h 2t minus cos 2t, 4 ones are 4 8s are, that is the L inverse of s upon s to the power 4 minus 16 is equal to 1 by 8 into cos h 2t minus cos 2t. Reference. Thank you.